In this video here from the Brassavola Little Stars, I have teamed up with Rez Quetzal, and I want to say thank you so much, Rez Quetzal, for approaching me. And let's get on with seeing how I take care of this orchid, my Brassavola Little Stars. And here I claim to talk about care. I thank you if you're going to stick to the end of the video, because when it comes to care, it is preferable, of course, to have a fantastic specimen size that can reflect successful care with any orchid. But sometimes care also means setback or stalled orchids. Clearly, my Brassavola Little Stars is not the example of a successful grown orchid that has bloomed and is vigorous in its growth habit. All these attributes are normal to Brassavola Little Stars. Very vigorous grower, prolific bloomer, beautiful nocturnal fragrance, which I have as yet to experience. But clearly you can see my little Brassavola is not all of that. My Brassavola Little Stars is very much stalled. It's not even set back. I would believe that upon receiving it 2.5 years ago, it was set back. By the time I got it with the next acclimating process, it completely stalled and slammed on the brakes and is not enjoying anything at the moment that the life and the looks of a Brassavola Little Stars should have. I am not going to put all the blame on the nursery. They send out what they send out. It's easy buy, easy sell. Get it out, get the products off to the customer. I'm not going to blame myself in this case either, because when I receive an orchid, at the time I was building this collection, I took the orchid, I cleaned it up, and I put it into my preferred setup of Leca and semi-hydro as soon as possible. And I did not consider, is it growing roots or isn't it? Especially with such a vigorous grower as the Little Stars, there was no need to be respectful or mindful of, is it growing roots or not? I had other orchids in the shipment of a similar stature with the Tourette leaves, Brassavola crosses, and Brassavola species, and did the same thing, and they just took off and grew really well. If I had bought this orchid as a single purchase, I would have been a little bit confused as to why it's not doing well. But seeing as I have others in comparison that came at the same time with a similar attributes and they just took off, this orchid was set back the time I got her and ground to a massive halt by the time I had repotted her. That was 2 years ago, 2.5. So yes, my care video is a little unconventional, but I'm caring for a stalled Brassavola Little Stars, and it may be of interest to see if somebody's having similar problems, what I do in order to hopefully still have this orchid around in a year's time, but doing much, much better. Well, first of all, if I see an orchid that is stressed, I am reluctant to intervene because that will stress the orchid out further. There are cases when it comes to rot or something like that, intervention is a must. There is no such thing going on here with my little stars. So for 2 years, she has been sitting in this pot, looking worse for wear and not performing as a typical little stars should. However, I am not intervening. If she goes downhill, I will have learned my lesson. But if she recovers, then we will all learn a lesson. Now, what you see here is basically how I got her. There hasn't been much change in 2 years, and that is how I know she's completely stalled. The little growths that I've tried to grow aren't very strong, and there are some roots going down into the pot, and I miss these on a regular basis because I'm treating her like a rescue. I do not take into consideration how much water or fertilizer she needs. I am only treating her now since 2 years as a complete and full-on rescue. I don't fertilize this orchid at all. There is no need. She is not growing well. What I would like to do is preserve and get some roots to get established in the pot. And she is starting to feel a little bit pot-bound, especially at this end. Now, another thing you might say is, well, that's a very short little Brassavola little stars. Yes, it is. Until she doesn't bloom for me properly, I won't know if I even have a little stars. But the label that I got her with is clear. It's a B little stars. So I'm going to continue to treat her as such. Sometimes she gets a little bit of seaweed. Now, during the winter months, she is not getting any seaweed whatsoever, but a daily misting just across the surface here to keep the humidity high in the pot and to make sure that those little roots that I have here, which really aren't that great, I make sure that they stay in a humid and wet environment. For the purpose of this video, I just want to show you that I only go in very gently at the base and around, just to keep those roots from drying out and getting desiccated against the Leca. I also keep the reservoir pretty full, considering that it's winter. Under any normal circumstances in other orchids, this would be far too full for me. But again, I'm trying to increase the humidity for the sake of the orchid so that she doesn't have to struggle with that as well. Usually they can take a humidity drop down to 40%. It's not ideal, but they can handle it. They are robust orchids. It's a very robust cross between the nodosa and the subulifolia. It should be a very vigorous grower. The humidity where I grow her, however, drops to 28%. Even now in winter, today, for example, I've got 32% humidity. For a rescue orchid, that is far too low, and especially if I'm growing with a media that has the tendency to dry out over the top. In the meantime, I have her positioned indoors, a shelf below where artificial lights are, full spectrum artificial lights. So she gets plenty of light, but it wouldn't be considered the bright light that she would require in order for her to bloom. The state that she's in right now, additional light would be far too much stress. And you can see she's okay with the leaves because there are some freckles. So she is getting enough light, and that is always a good sign. If there is a little bit of freckling going on, then in these orchids, it's a good thing because that means her light levels that she's receiving are adequate. So she's not directly under full spectrum light, but a shelf below that. It's about 80 centimeters off the top of the orchid to where the light is. And then on top of her, there are other orchids also shading her a little bit from the artificial lights. And in the summer, when it's really hot, I keep her indoors. She doesn't come outdoors. I baby her on a very bright shelf that does not get any direct sun whatsoever. They wouldn't mind a little bit of dappled sunlight. They don't want direct sunlight. In my climate, that would toast them. But a bit of dappled sun here and there is not a problem. Under a stressful situation that I find mine in, there is no way that additional light than she's getting already would do her any good whatsoever. And the temperatures I'm keeping her at are what I have available as ambient air in my dining room. And this winter it dropped as low as 14 degrees Celsius, which for this orchid is not a problem because she can, under normal circumstances, as a healthy orchid, go as low as 6 to 8 degrees Celsius at night. So that's not an issue at all. In future, if she makes it, if she pulls through, I will be able to have her outdoors all year round without any problems whatsoever. In the summer, my indoor setup where she will then be living closer to the glass, because of the angle of the sun, there is no direct sun, but she will get bright light. The temperatures can always range up to 30, 40 degrees Celsius. As long as I keep her humid around the surface and on the bottom of the pot, make sure the reservoir is full in order to maximize the humidity, she can handle that. The question is she going to pull through with a few more substantial growths that give me another root system? Because what I would like to do actually is go in and take out everything that doesn't look right in the middle here. There is no rot. Everything is solid. Everything is firm. There is no rot whatsoever. But just to clean her up, because she's been in this pot now over 2 years. In her weakened state, I will not intervene. Not until I see signs of something that is actually conducive to she's coming around and she's going to need a cleaner environment and setup so that whatever grows now will not be disturbed again for another 2 years so that she can pick up some strength. I am hopeful that this end here will provide me with a Brassavola little stars that will make sense in the future. It is possible that this end here might start to become something of substance, but you see how small the growths are, so there's no promises here. I might get a chance on this end. That's how I take care of my completely stalled Brassavola little stars, and you can see how quickly the wind out here starts to dry the surface off before I put her back on her shelf inside. I'm seriously hoping that when we do an update, Rez Quetzal and I, and anybody else who wants to join in on this care collab video, I'm really, really hoping that I can show you a successful outcome of how I took care of this orchid for 2.5 years. And now in the growing season of 2021, she will progress and become something a little bit more healthy and happy. Rez Quetzal, thank you so much for approaching me. Thank you for pointing out that we have little stars as the same orchid. I appreciate this care collab very, very much. Again, if anybody else has this orchid and you see this video a little bit further down the line, please feel free to contact any of us. The links of the corresponding video from Rez Quetzal will be in the description below, and then we'll be very, very happy to bring you on board for subsequent updates. I appreciate having you here very much. Have yourselves a wonderful day, and please stay safe. Take care. Bye.